Well, Australians are a step closer to an overseas trip today, with the federal government rolling out technology that proves your COVID-19 vaccine status around the world. For more, we are joined by Tourism and Transport Forum Chief Margie Osman. Margie, always nice to see you. How do these vaccine certificates work?
Well, look, it's not all that different to what we're seeing in New South Wales at this point in time with the QR code and downloading your certificate onto that mechanism. You've got to have a MyGov account, you need to link it to your Medicare account, and you need to go into the Medicare mechanism and link it to your passport. It's really that simple. And then you just use one of the international travel apps like the IATA one. This is world-leading technology, so bravo, Australia.
All right, so get your luggage out. November 1, as we know, is when international flights will resume. Is that enough time for the aviation industry to be ready?
Well, look, I think it is for what we're probably going to see in the first instance, which is lots of visiting friends and family. I mean, we're not going to see a rush of tourists to Australia until we've actually sorted out the quarantine issue, and hopefully there isn't any quarantine. And in addition to that, open borders internally, because gorgeous as New South Wales is, this is usually a trip of a lifetime for people. They come here so they can go to the Opera House, the Great Barrier Reef, Uluru, Mingaloo, the Barossa, you name it. So we need some certainty around those borders.
How expensive do you reckon those first flights will be?
Well, look, capacity is an issue for us at the moment. One of the things that's happened because we weren't open to travel is all of those aeroplanes and pilots have gone elsewhere in the world. So it is going to be supply and demand. But I'm sure that the airlines are going to be working very hard to keep the prices down because they want you back in the air as quickly as possible.
Now, you would have noticed this too, the language around reopening Queensland is shifting. Do you expect the border to be open for Christmas?
Well, I am the eternal optimist and I think the border will be open for Christmas. I just think, you know, from the tourism industry's perspective up there, they're in so much pain, particularly those businesses that have got 70% plus international exposure.
Yeah, we would have noticed two big incentives on offer from today to get Queenslanders holidaying at home. I mean, it's something that the tourism industry up there really needs, isn't it?
Absolutely. And look, really smart move by the Queensland government to do this. You know, it gives them a bit of insurance if that border doesn't open to the southern states. It means that Queenslanders hopefully have taken up as many bookings as possible and keeps the industry afloat.
All right. Good stuff, Margie. Good to talk to you this morning. Have a good week.